Hey there, guys, it's Liz here. Thank you so much for tuning in. Because if you are one of those people that feels like you're at a standstill when it comes to your fat loss, or honestly, even if it's health and healing in general, this is the training for you. And if you know anybody else that may be in that same position, please do me a favor and either tag them in the comments, send it to them in a private message if you need to, share it on your feed. I'd really appreciate that. It means the world to me, because we are going to be diving into three really important variables that I want you guys to start considering and addressing, because they have the ability to help you break through this extremely frustrating state in a health journey. Because how many of you guys have been there before? Do me a favor and drop a one in the comments if you have ever been to the point where you're like, listen, I'm staying compliant to a meal plan, I'm going and getting my workouts in, or I'm, you know, taking these really great quality supplements, but I ain't losing any weight, and you know, I'm not restoring my energy, I'm not getting my vitality back, whatever your goal is. Like, how frustrating has that been? I know I've been there before, where I'm like, listen, if I'm not gonna have energy, then I don't really care what I eat, might as well order Domino's, bring on the freaking pizza. Drop a one below if that is you. I see you guys rolling it in right now, because this is the thing that's going to derail you from continuing on. And so I want you to know that it's not you that's broken. Right? And it may not even necessarily be that your meal plan is bad or that your workouts aren't sufficient. It absolutely could be one of these other three factors that we need to address. So here we go. All right, who's excited? Give me some hearts. All right. So these are in no particular order because they're all important. But the first one I'm going to talk about is slowed metabolic rate. So what's that mean? Like, slowed metabolism. We've all kind of said, oh, okay, well, if I'm not losing fat, maybe my metabolism is slow, all right? So I want you guys to understand, though, how that can happen. So it can happen from reduced calorie intake, because maybe you've been trying to be low calorie for so long that your body is adjusting your metabolism to the amount of food you're taking in, because it's smart. Because it's smart, right? How many of you guys have done that? Do me a favor, drop a two in the comments. If you've been there where you're like, you know what? You try and do caloric restriction and hope that that works. I would be dropping a two. That was me. I absolutely did that for years before I knew any better. Okay. So it could be caloric restriction. It could also be the fact that maybe you have a certain health condition that it's going to put you more in this survival state. And so when your body's in this survival state, or it's in that fight or flight state, that it's not necessarily prioritizing fat loss. Like, its goal is to keep you alive. And, you know, it's also not going to prioritize things like sex hormones and other things that can be contributing to your health problems. So guys, decreased metabolic rate or slowed metabolism, it's more than just not losing as much weight. It's more than just not losing as much fat. It really is the fact that your body's not going to prioritize making sex hormones because it needs it for fight or flight response. Okay, so that's one. That's one. Two is your toxic load. And I love your guys' feedback here. So do me a favor, because so many people ask, well, like, what does that mean? And I'm going to explain it to you in a minute. But if you would like, I've been thinking about putting together like a little questionnaire, like survey for you guys to be able to kind of assess your own toxic load. Do me a favor and just put toxic load in the comments if this sounds like something that would be like attractive to you or something that you would want, because you can have toxins accrue from conventional or, you know, processed foods that you're eating. You can have it from heavy metals that have been in your mouth. You may have amalgam silver fillings. You could have exposure to mold. It doesn't even have to be like visually, you know, in your home. It could be from the coffee you drink every day that has ochratoxin A, because that's extremely common. It could be from your tap water. You know, you can have chlorine or fluoride in your tap water, you know, personal care products, cleaning products. So if you want, if this sounds like something, because I was just thinking of that as I was going through getting ready for this live, if this sounds like something that would be interesting to you and you guys want to have a list of all the things that can contribute to your toxic load, put toxic load in the comments and I may put that together and have you guys be able to do that so you can assess and see where you stand. I do this with every single client that comes in with me and we assess and see where they're at. And I'm thinking about offering that to you guys if that's something that enough people would be interested in. So do me a favor, put that in the comments, let me know. So what are the issues with having toxins besides the fact that, hello, they're toxic? Guys, when you have more toxins in your body, one of the big ways that your body protects you from them is it surrounds them with fat, so that it's not going to get to certain parts of your body and especially your brain. So it's a protective mechanism. So you guys, you can be doing all the other right things, But if you're holding on to certain toxins, I mean, I had a client that was holding on to mold. She didn't even realize that she had mold issues and how much mold was in her house. And, you know, once she ended up detoxing from that, it was amazing how the fat started to come off and how the energy started to be restored. So toxins play such a huge role, such a huge role. And then third is gut health. You guys, if you follow me long enough, you know that this is super important, but like, what is affecting gut health? It can be an imbalance in your microbiome because, you know, you don't have enough of the right prebiotics or the right type of probiotic in your diet, right? You could have leaky gut. You absolutely could have leaky gut leading to more inflammation. So that's a big thing there as well. When your body's inflamed, it ain't trying to let go of weight, let me tell you. And then you can also have these toxins that we just talked about. Again, toxins, I just talked about this in my Vitality Factor small group coaching program. We just did an entire training on this because I wanted them to know, listen, these are all of the stressors that you don't even think about on a regular basis. Things like tap water, where if you're like I was 5, 6, 7 years ago, honestly, I was like, okay, you know, water is water when it comes to tap water versus bottled water. I don't think there's that much difference. It's not that big of a deal. Well, I was completely oblivious and naive then, but things such as tap water alone can be ruining your gut, can kill off the bacteria in your gut with all the chlorine in there. So I went into all of this detail with Vitality Factor and taught them about that, but I wanted to give you guys a couple of examples of what things can be destroying your gut health that you may not even be aware of. Because if you're taking birth control, I've talked about that before, you know, taking antibiotics, taking, you know, Aleve or taking, you know, aspirin, different types of, you know, NSAIDs will completely ruin your gut. You guys, have acid blockers are huge for ruining gut health. So if you're someone that deals with acid reflux and indigestion and you go and you try and do, you know, maybe you're doing Gaviscon or you're doing Zantac or was that the one that was just taken off the shelf? Yeah, Prilosec, even things like Tums and Pepto-Bismol, guys, that changes your microbiome, changes your gut health. So that plays a huge role in there as well. There's a lot of things, which is why I really think after we just talk about this more, as I'm kind of talking this out with you guys, that toxic load thing is probably a really valuable tool for you. So if you didn't already, put it in the comments because I know this would be super helpful for you guys. But those are the three main factors that, guys, if you're doing everything else right and it seems like you're just broken or you feel like this is just how you're genetically supposed to be, please know that there are answers out there. You just, at this point, up until now, haven't known the right questions to ask. And so that's what my prayer is every time I come on here, is that I give you one more question that you need to start asking yourself, whether you decide to move forward with me and we're doing, you know, customized coaching or you're in my small group coaching program, we address those things there, or you're going to a practitioner and maybe this is just a question that you want to bring to their attention. I want to equip you with what you need to be able to get to your goals, to be able to heal, to get into that restorative state, and to be able to get your life back. So if you guys have any additional questions, as always, put them in the comments, and anything that I don't get while I'm live, I get to it afterwards. So have a blessed week, guys. Thank you for tuning in, and I will see you next time.